Lily Stone, 25, switches on her bedside lamp. She sits up in bed, tears running down her cheeks. Begin flashback. 13 years ago, Lily's childhood home, day. Young Lily, 8 years old, walks up the front steps to the house in front of her brother, teenage Leaf, 16, and his friend Hunter, 16.
Leaf, fuck, man, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. Fuck does he think he is? He doesn't get to call me his son.
Try not to read too much into it. Hasn't been that long since your dad's funeral. I'm sure your dad's boss was just trying to be comforting or something.
Whatever.
Lily, Leaf, and Hunter enter the house. Lily runs ahead to her room.
Look, man, do me a favor and watch Lily till my mom gets home. Give me a break.
Leaf walks to his bedroom and closes the door. Hunter is in the hallway when he hears Nirvana blasting from Leaf's room. Hunter walks towards Lily's bedroom, where she sits on her bed playing with Barbie dolls.
Hey, Lily, what's up in Barbie land?
This is Rapunzel Barbie. She has the longest hair out of all of my Barbies. I can brush her hair all the way down to the bottom, and it even goes past her feet, see?
Wow, Lil, she's really pretty.
Hunter sits next to her on the bed.
You know who else is really pretty? You are, Lily. You are really pretty. Tell you what, let's play hairdresser. You brush Barbie's hair, and I'll do yours. Sound fun?
Mm-hmm. My mom's too busy to play hairdresser anymore, and Leaf hates to play with me.
Well, I'm happy to play, but I can't brush your hair if you're all the way over there. Come sit here on my lap.
Okay. Can you do a French braid?
I don't know. I've never tried, but it's important to always try new things, right? Your mom must tell you that all the time. I love the way your hair feels, Lily. I love to touch it. You want to touch my hair?
No. Girls don't like to do that to boys.
Well, I know something that girls do like to do to boys. Do you feel how hard my lap is while you're sitting? Girls like to help boys with that. Hey, I've got a good idea. Let's play a new game.
End flashback. Present. Lily's bedroom dawn. Lily wipes the tears from her face. Hotel bedroom. Ryder Bishop awakens in bed next to Natalia Konovalova.
I know you don't want more with me. And that's okay, we're not in love. But I want to be. At least with someone who can love me back. And that's not gonna happen if you keep distracting me every time you come into town.
Ryder, so sweet. You deserve what I cannot give.
The valet grabs Ryder's car keys from the lockbox and heads to retrieve the car. He returns promptly, brakes noisily, jumps out of the car, holds open the door.
The car is freaking dope. I bet you get laid all the time with a car like this. Hey, listen, maybe you can just give me some tips for now. I would love to make it big in business like you.
Tips? Yeah, sure. Clean up your image and your attitude. Grow up. And do you really think people are gonna take you seriously like this? Do you think you're entitled to anything? Yeah, you're a valet, so what? I once drove a tow truck, now I own a fucking fleet. That's a business tip.
Ryder hands him $100 bill.
And here's a cash tip. The next time I see you, you better make sure you've earned the right to both of these. Otherwise, you won't be working here anymore.
Yeah. And how do you know that?
Because I own the hotel.
Once again, you aren't seeing in yourself the reality that everyone else already knows. You're knockout, Lily, and smart and funny. God, just because he's successful doesn't mean he has to be out of reach. You're just as important a person as he is.
While Ryder sits back down, Jack opens the door and Lily enters. She goes to the desk, puts down the coffees, leaning over, exposing a bit of cleavage. Lily brings a coffee to Ryder, but accidentally spills some on his hand.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry. Here, let me wipe that off for you.
Lily grabs some napkins, kneels down in front of Ryder, and begins to blot his pants.
By the way, Lily Stone, Ryder Bishop, Ryder Bishop, Lily Stone. Well, now that the introductions are done, I think I'll just run down to marketing for a minute. Get those papers you wanted. So, you know, yeah.
Hello, ladies. Welcome to Club Wicked. Congratulations to the bride. I am Shlomo, and this is my wife, Aurora. We are the owners of the club. Aurora's here to take you on a private tour of the upper floors of the club.
The upper floors are off limits until midnight. But since you're all new to the club, we prefer to offer a private viewing first.
The girls follow Aurora up the narrow staircase, Love Wicked rooftop patio.
No, wait a sec, you're here. Are you fucking kidding me? Do you stop much?
When you mentioned this place, I had to call in the favor from my friends. They own the place. I didn't mean to scare you, but I really, really wanted to see you. Are you embarrassed?
Mm-hmm.
Don't you dare cover yourself up. You are so beautiful. Look at me, Lily. What's so funny? Your laughing right now doesn't bode so well for my ego.
I'm not laughing at you, okay? Not at all. It's just that this is such a shock to see you here, of all places. And you're seeing me dressed like this, which is completely out of character for me, and I can't believe what this place is. And I'm standing here in it, and you're here now, and look at me like this. What? Why are you smiling? You're not smiling. Why are you smiling?
You're babbling.
Yeah.
And it's fucking sexy, so.
I'm not tired. Take me home. To your place.
Ryder's condo, bedroom, night. Ryder lies Lily on the bed, his body balanced above hers. He leans in to kiss her.
God, baby, I want you so fucking bad. But you need to tell me what you want. I'm not gonna push you.
What I want? I hope I'm making it very clear. I want you, Ryder.
Baby, you are so exquisite. You're a flower, Lily. Such a perfect flower. I don't want to crush you, but I'm truly finding it hard to contain myself right now.
Then don't.
God, I want to explode.
And stop holding back. I want you.
I'm never going to stop telling you this. One day, I hope you'll believe me. I see how difficult it is for you to accept and acknowledge your beauty, so if you struggle with that, I'll make sure to always remind you.
Lily smiles, a tear runs down her cheek. Ryder brushes it away.
My brother's friend, Hunter, when I was 7 years old, he molested me.
His emotions run the gamut. Anger, disgust, hurt, betrayal, utter sadness. When Lily finishes, Ryder pulls her close.
Lily, I'm so sorry. I can see you were struggling. I never imagined. I can't even begin to understand the pain you must feel. How much this must haunt you. I would do anything to be able to take this away from you. I'm in love with you. I've loved you from the first moment I saw you at Jagged Edge. I know. Telling you this now probably makes me a grade A asshole, but I need you to know you are so loved. You don't need to say it back. You don't need to feel the same way about me right now. I have no right to ask that of you, but I can't lie to myself about how much I adore you. And if my loving you can erase even a tiny portion of this anguish.
I'm in love with you too.
Thank you. For trusting me with this. I will never, ever hurt you.
You did a lot of shit, Ryder. But over the last few weeks of being without you, I've also realized some really important things about myself. Like, for the better. And without you, I was terrified that I would lose all that incredible progress that I made. But you know what? I didn't. I didn't crawl back under a rock and wither, and I didn't succumb to old habits and beliefs about myself. I didn't once blame myself for what has happened to me.
I want you. Let me make that very clear. What do you want?
You know, for someone who is, just come here.
Lily grabs Ryder by his shirt collar, pulls his head down toward hers, and kisses deeply. Flash forward, beach house in the Maldives.
Ah, okay, no. Don't you start that up again. I'm gonna hop in the shower. I will be out in a few minutes.
We should probably think.
I got this out.
I got the brush.
Beach, afternoon, later. Lily and Ryder walk out of the beach house and onto the beach. They hold hands and head toward their friends. The end. Yay!
Each of the characters that we created was varied.
Well, you write
specific,
what you know.
But
the abuse
the
was
abuse
real.
And
the BDD is real.
Yeah. And so a lot of the psychology behind what we wrote was very real. And I think it represented both of us. So.
Yeah. We tried to take the best of each of us and combine them to make one awesome woman.
So yeah, I think what it really comes down to is that a lot of this was for us really realistic to us because it was a lot of reality that we've experienced.
It was very cathartic.
Yeah. Ultimately, I took like pages of notes, not on acting or anything like that, but on what your interpretations were and then how the scene actually worked out. Because we've never heard of it except for ourselves.
Yeah.
I thought it was terrific.
Ryder kisses Lily's lips hard, sliding his tongue into her mouth.
Lily is applying her right
foot. Ryder is lying on his back. Lily runs her hand down his throat toward
his penis. Ryder takes on one of Lily's breasts into his mouth, sucking gently.
Ryder moves his hand down towards Lily's vagina.
Lily's legs part.
Ryder takes a condom and places it on his penis. He places himself on top of Lily.
Ryder thrusts himself repeatedly into Lily. Lily scrapes her fingers down Ryder's glistening back to warn his ass. She squeezes his ass as his buttocks flexes.